Bande Guru Pada Dandam Bhakta Vinda Samannitam Sri Chaitanya Prabhum Bande Nitta Ananda Sahoditam Sri Nanda Nandanam Bande Radhika Charno Dayam Gopijana Samayuktam Binda Pancha-kalpa-daru-vasya-kipa-sandh-vavacha Patitanam pavane-bhavishnabhi-bhyo-namo-nama Mukankaroti-vacha-lang-pangung-lang-haiti-giram Yat-kipa-tam-hang-bandhi-paramananda-madhama Vrindavaitu-sidhe-vai-piyavai-kesu-vasya-cha Shnabhakti Pade Devi Sattva Vattvai Namo Nama Narayana Namaskritta Naranchaiva Narottama Deving Saraswating Vyasam Tato Jayo Mudiri Sankirtane Krishna Katho Padeshe Gauriya Patrasya Prakasanecha Sadhanurapta Guru Bhakti Yukto Bhakti Pramodaksha Jagodvaranya Deyam Sadapari Bhavagnam Avishtaduham Tethas Padam Siva Virinchinutam Saranyam Vetatiham Banotopal Bhavadiputam Bande Mahapurushate Charana Ravindam Yat-pāda-pallava-nakha-chanda-mani-chataya Vishwari-jita-kema-pika-bhava-dushu-adarsha Purna-nurāgura-sa-sāgura-sāra-mūti Sārāthika-mai-kada-kripa-mukarasha Sri Krishna-caitanya-prabhu-netta-ananda Siyad-daita-gadā-dhara-siva-sadhi-gaura-bhakta-binda Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Siva Sadi Gaura Bhakta Binda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare Hare Ajanulambita Bhujau Kanaka Badat Sankirtanaika Vitaru Kamala Yataksha Vishambaru Dijavaru Jugadhar Mopalu Bande Jagat Priya Karu Karuna Bhataru Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare Hare Namami Gange Tava Padu Pankajam Sura surair vandito dibharupam Bhuktin cha muktin cha dada sinitam Bhavanurupena sada naranam Ganga taranga ramaniya jata kalapam Gauri nirantara vibhushito mam bhagam Narayano Priyamananga Madapuharam Varanasi Purapati Bhajavishanatham Bhagisha Jushvadane Lakshmir Yasacha Bhakshasi Jasyasthi Hidaya Sambhid Pam Nisingha Maham Bhaji Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Bhavap Bharga Brahmato Yada Bhavijanas Satarhi Achyuta Satsamagama Satsangamajarhi Tadeva Sadagatu Parāvareṣitaihi jayate matihi bhavāpavargo brahmato yadā bhavijjanasya tarhi acyuta satsamāgama satsangam jarhi tadaiva sadgato parāvareṣitaihi jayate ratihi Gaudiya Goshtipati Sri Śrīla Bhakti Siddhānta Saraswati Goswami Thakura Prabhupāda Jagadguru told, bonded soul can never get inspiration until and unless bonded soul can see a glowing example in front of them. In front of them, if there is no example, idealism, glowing idealism, in that case, bonded souls, so poor, they cannot get inspiration to do bhajan. It is not possible. Bhagavan is surely under the control of devotees. I am going to explain this sloka, then you can understand. Surely, Bhagavan is under the control of pure devotees. Though we know that devotees, they are Shakti Tattva. Gauru Shakti Sarupayo Rupanugo Varayate, we speak na, this way, Shakti Tattva. But still, Bhagavan is under the control of pure devotees. So, pure devotees, they are doing pure seva, and by the help of the seva, when pure devotees, they are doing pure seva from heart, then Bhagavan automatically become under the control of those devotees. So, according to this conception, we know that the devotees, they can keep Supreme Lord inside their heart under control. If devotees, they are not powerful, then how they can serve Bhagavan by the help of seva? How they can, you know, satisfy Supreme Lord? That is the main question. That's why Bhagavan speaking, aham bhakto paradhino evo, aham bhakto paradhino hi asatantra evo dijo. Though we know Adyakan Tattva is not under any control of anybody, but still, he is surely under the control of pure devotees, aham bhakto paradhino. Without understanding the bhava of Supreme Lord, how devotees can serve? That is the main question. If I cannot understand the heart of Supreme Lord, then how I can serve? That is the main question. So, we are sure that Bhagavan is Antaryami. Bhagavan is Antaryami, Bhagavan can know everything. And those devotees, they can also understand the heart of devotee, heart of Bhagavan. Bhagavan is Antarjami. Bhagavan can know everything. We know. Bhagavan can understand everything. But one special thing is there. Devotees, they can understand the heart of Bhagavan. That is the main thing. So, Bhavapa Bharga Bhamato Yada Bhavit Janasya Tarhi Achyuta Satsamagama Satsangama Jarhi Tadaiva Sadagato Paravareshya Tvai Yayate Mati or somewhere it is written Rati. Okay. Actually, Jivatma is a single spark of, just like a single spark of fire. Chit Surjo. Bhagavan is Chit Surjo, spiritual sun. And in Upanishad it is compared that those teeny jivas, infinitesimal jiva, they are just like a spark of fire or rays coming from photon kana, photon particle coming from sun. Though jivatma is a very infinitesimal chit particle, but still it can be compared with a single spark of fire. Why? A single spark of fire in contact with the inflammable object can ignite, you know, a raging conflagration capable of consuming the entire world. Is possible. Though it is spark, very small, it can be compared with the spark of fire. I mean, Tulsidas ji speaking, many times before I told, Sadguru mile bhed batame gyan kare upadesh, kaila ka maila shuti jat aank kare pravesh. Previous days I was discussing how Bhagavan trying his best to give a Sarukshapti kipa to all jivatmas through devotees. So, a single spark of fire in contact with inflammable object can ignite, I told. Similarly, a jiva who attains the ultimate object Krishna prema, divine love of Krishna, can inundate the entire universe with Krishna prema. It's possible. Though very small particle, chidatma, but it's still, all those previous days I was discussing, Bhaktivinoda was speaking, Krishna going to provide different kind of opportunities to bonded soul. Though bonded soul, they are not ready to do vajan still. Krishna going to provide the different kind of facilities, opportunities, right from this material ahankar up to ekdam Krishna prema, high stage of mahabhava, bhava. Krishna giving different kind of chance to bonded soul. If at all they can take this kind of chance, they can come out successful. With this hope, Krishna is always trying his best. But anadi vahirmukh, for infinity pure jivatma averse to Krishna seva. Previous day also I was discussing one sloka from Bhagavatam. Janasya krishnad vimukhasya daivad adharma silasya sudukkitasya anugruhayeha charanti nunam bhutani bhavyani janardhanasya. Those are messengers of Supreme Lord, those personal associates of Supreme Lord, Janardhan, they are traveling around this material world in search of such a jivatma who is little bit, you know, in favor of Krishna bhajan. Janasya krishnat vimukhasya daiva adharma silasya sudukkita, they are, you know, they cannot get any chance to do bhakti, Krishna seva, eternal seva. Krishna bhuli shei jiv anadi vairmukh atayib mayatare day Krishna mayatare day sansarati du. We are speaking this philosophy, but we'll have to practically feel. We'll have to do bhajan, nam bhajan, go into deep meditation, and we'll have to feel all this practically. Not that philosophically we can only discuss, not that. Practically we like to feel. So, though jivatma infinitesimal, still, janasya krishnat vimukhasya daimat, those who are averse to Krishna, Those are messengers of Supreme Lord, personal associates of Supreme Lord. They are traveling around in search of such a jiva whom they can bestow kipa. So many cases I can give example from Bhagavatam. Chittaketu Raja, you know, is a big king. He was not doing Krishna bhajan. Materially attached in kingdom, you know, affluences, everything. So many wives, but there is no children, no baby. So ultimately, you know, ultimately, by the mercy of Narad Ji Maharaj, he came to know. He came to know the absolute truth. This way, actually, first of all, he was asking for the blessing so that he can get a baby. So, he was successful. Angira Rishi, and ultimately, finally came Narad Ji and Angira Rishi. So, the baby lived body, going to live body. Then after that, he was mad, just materially attached, na? Tavad bhayam davina deho suhit nivittvam tavad tavat soko spriha paribhava vipulas chalovaha. This sloka I discussed many times. Tavad bhayam davina deho suhit nivittvam. You are going to feel fear. Always you are going to fear. I can lose money. I can lose position. I can lose this, that. Tavad bhayam. Drabina deho suhit, for this material body, position, properties. Always you are sometime, some kind of unknown force. Sometime of unknown, you know, fear falling. Tavad bhayam drabina deho suhit nimita. Tavas priha paribhava vipulas chalova. Huge amount of greed. All the time falling. Ultimately, when the boy going to die, then king was crying in such a way so that he is also going to leave body. Finally, Angira Rishi and Naraji Maharaj bestow kipa on him, and same case, like Sivas Pandit going to leave, Sivas Pandit, his, you know, son going to leave body, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asking that Jivatma, hey Jivatma, again Mahaprabhu calling, again Mahaprabhu calling this Jivatma. And Jivatma coming and enter again this body, and Mahaprabhu asking, hey Jivatma, why you are going to leave this body? As soon as Jivatma speaking, well, my connection is over here. Up to this point, I was in connection with this family. Now this connection is over, I will have to fly to some other place. Jivatma entering this body, dead body, and speaking. And Mahaprabhu wanted to establish this tattva that according to karma fall, Jivatma wandering around this material world, here and there. Actually, Jivatma has no connection with this matter. I already told Maya, but still, Jivatma is always in problem. Same case here, Chittaketu Raja crying, and finally Naraji Maharaj Angira Rishi came here to give tattva gyan to this Chittaketu Raja. And there also Jivatma coming inside his dead body, and that Jivatma speaking that now here my connection is over, I will have to fly to some other place. This way, when Chittaketu Raja could see and see this, you know, see this thing, Then automatically Dibya Gyan came inside her. And those rishis giving kipa to him. And finally he was Tattva Gyani, big. He was enjoying the leadership of all Vidyadhar. He was enjoying the total, you know, leadership of Vidyadhar. Oh, great, you know. Sankarsan, he could take darshan of Sankarsan, Sankarsan giving kipa. So Shankar Bhagavan and Chittaketu Maharaj, both of them are the disciples of Sankarsan Bhagavan, Sankarsan. Anyway, this way is possible. Bonded soul in Maya cannot realize what power can come. They cannot realize. Here actually we are going to discuss this point that Janasya Krishnat Bhimukashudaya Adharma Silasudu Onugruhayeho is reading affirmative, giving guarantee. Onugruhayeho, surely to give kipa, to bestow kipa on bonded soul, those associates of Bhagavan, they are traveling here and there to help bonded soul, to help bonded souls to get bhakti. Here also, Baba Apavargu Bhavati, it is Muchukundo. You heard the name of Muchukundo. Muchukundo, you know, praying in front of Supreme Lord, and this one kind of prayer. Baba Apavarga Brahmato Yada Bhavet Janasya Tarhi Achyuta Satsamaga. Here's some speciality of this law. Baba Apavarga Brahmato Yada Bhavet Janasya Tarhi Achyuta Satsamaga. Satsangama Jarhi Tadaiva Sadagatu Parapara Ishetvai Yathri. Krishna Bhaktir Janma Mool Hai Sadhu Sangha. This is also going to prove this point. When the material life of a wandering soul, when the material life of a wandering soul has come to an end, O Chuta, that jiva can attain the association of your devotees. And when that jivatma get the association of pure devotees, then and there awakens a mood of devotion. Like one fire, I can give example also, maybe you forget, maybe some days before I was discussing, though this discussion I will have to do again. Achajur Aranir Adyo Sad Anteva Ushuttar Arani Tat Sandhyanam Pravachanam Vidda Sandhi Sukhavaha. Bhagavan Sri Krishna is going to speak to Uddhav. The Guru is the wooden base, one wooden base, and the disciple is the upper wooden piece on the top. And aprakita harikatha from the lotus mouth of a powerful acharyas, practicing acharyas, sadhu, can act as a kindling stick. And transcendental knowledge can manifest inside the heart of that disciple. I mean, two wooden pieces dry, if you go on friction, then you can find some fire can come out. Forest fire, this way, forest fire taking place, you know already, you have experience, I think. I have seen in Vrindavan, long ago I was staying, that time temperature was around 45, 47, so high temperature. Suddenly there was some dry, you know, due to Lu mean hot air blowing, and all trees their friction, due to friction, you know. All trees are dry, dry wooden pieces are there, and due to strong wind, they are going to get the chance to, you know, get friction. And after the suddenly fire coming out. It is called fire, forest fire, this way coming out. So this point I can discuss after, but still I give the example. In the example, potency is already there in Jivatma. Only you need the help of Sadguru, Vaishnava, their idealism, a glowing example. So by watching them, if you are going to get Kripa, then surely you can get a spiritual fire inside your heart. That's the same thing I was speaking. I was giving a single spark of fire in contact with an inflammable object can ignite. I was speaking. Same thing. This way actually you can understand. Though potency is there, but automatically Jivatma cannot start bhakti. Sarup Shakti Vritti cannot come automatically. Sarup Shakti Vritti cannot come automatically. That I was discussing previous Harikatha. Achajyar Aranir Adyaha Swad Antevashi Uttararani Tat Sandhyanam Prabachanam Vidya Sandhi Sukhavaha. This way, just like forest fire, one wooden log, dashing, pushing, friction going on, suddenly fire can come out. This way, the guru is the wooden base one, and the disciple is the upper wooden piece, a lower wooden piece, this one, guru base, and aprakita harikatha from the lotus mouth of a powerful acharya, practicing acharya, sadhu, can act as a kindling stick, and the transcendental knowledge, spiritual fire, which can bring aprakita sukhanubhuti inside the heart of the disciple. The kindling stick means glowing fire of aprakita sevanubhuti. Try to understand. The kindling streak means glowing fire of aprakita sevanubhuti. Because what? Gurudev or Vaishnava, what they can give? They can inculcate the actual sevanubhuti. They are serving Supreme Lord all the 24 hours continuously, non-stop. They are enjoying doing seva. And this direct feeling, Gurudev can inculcate inside the heart of devotees. I mean, disciple, inclined disciple. Follow. Aprakita subhas, sevanubhuti. The direct feeling of aprakita seva can touch the heart of disciple from the heart of Gurudev. If there is no love, no prema, how you can do seva? So it's one kind of, you know, contagious disease. So many examples there in Bhagavatam. Without the help of Guru Vaishnava, without the kripa of pure Guru Vaishnava, it is not possible for us to get the kripa of Sarup Shakti. Is the arrangement of Supreme Lord. We'll have to get it. In seven canto also, same. Like the sloka I previously speak, Jano so Krishna divimukho shodayivad adharma sulasya sudukhitasya anugruhayeho charantinunam bhutani bhavyani janardanasya. Same thing. In seventh canto, Prahladma is speaking, Naishang mati stavaduru kramangim sprishyattanarthap gomo jadartho mahi asampadrajo visekam niskinchananam no brinito yavat. Follow. So many slokas you can get. Ruhu ganaistat tapasan yati na che jaya nirvapanad grihadva na chandasan iva jalagni surjoir bina mahat padarajo visekam. It is from Pip Canto. So you see in Naishangmati stavadukram urukramangis, you know, Naishangmati stavad urukramangin speciati. Anarthapagamo yadartho mahiyo sampadarajo visekam niskinchananam na vrinito javat. Persons who are absorbed in bodily identification, busy with material things, those who fail to understand the necessity to free themselves from materialistic habits, they are not feeling any necessity to go out of Maya, and who not going to take the dust particle from the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava. You know, to take bath, you know, they cannot understand. If they have the chance to take dust particle from the lotus feet of great devotees who are fully detached from mundane sense objects, for such persons, there is no possibility that their consciousness can touch the glories of Sri, you know, they cannot touch Urukramangri. Urukram mean Krishna. If they are not going to get the chance to take bath by the dust particle from the lotus feet of pure devotees, Urukramangri, Urujar Kram, Uru mane huge, infinitely powerful Bhagavan, in respect of Leela, in respect of power, all. So they cannot touch, they have no power to touch the lotus feet of Krishna. They cannot. Naishang mati stavat kuru kramangin spishati. They can do so many things. They can show so many capacity, efficiency, but until and unless they are going to take kripa from the lotus feet of those pure devotees, Naishangmati stavat urukramanging, spirituality anarthava, so that all anartha can go away. If you are going to take dust particle from the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava, in Chaitanya Charitamrita already written, Uchishta prasadam of Guru Vaishnava, water was of the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava and the dust particles, bhakta bhukta avashes, Bhaktapada Jal, Bhaktapada Renu, Tin Bhajaner Bal. These three are huge, powerful, can give you immense power. All anartha can go away, and you can get the chance to understand the glories of Sri Krishna. I mean, you can start seva. Our Ruhu Ganesh, same thing in fifth canto. Ruhu ganesh tat tapasana yati na chijjaya nirvapanat gihatva na chandasana iva jalagni surjoir bina mahat padarajovi sekam. O Ruhugan, Bhagavan cannot be known by any amount of astuties of penances. Same thing Mahaprabhu speaking to Suklambar Brahmachari. What do you think? You are drinking milk, so you think you can get the kippa of Bhagavan? What do you think? Mahaprabhu speaking to Suklambar, even those Asura, they are also doing astridian penance. So what? Asura top kare tai ki ba fall. Hiranyakashipu doing tapasya, na bhutam na bhavishyati. So, this way Mahaprabhu chiding. He wanted to chastise this, you know. Suklambar Brahmachari, you think you are drinking milk, you are doing astridian penance, so you can get kippa of Bhagavan, take darshan of Bhagavan? What do you think? Oh, Ruhugan, Bhagavan cannot be known by any amount of austerities or finance, or by worship, or by giving one's home, I mean going to leave home, one to enter into renounce order, nor indeed by living or by leading household life, nothing. No way he cannot get the kippa. Ruhu ganaistat tapasana yati na chejjaya nirvapanat grihadba na chandasa naiva jalagni surjoi na chandasa. Bhagavan, he cannot be known by reciting simply Vedas nor by worshipping the demigods like sun god, moon god, you know, water, Jal Devata, Varun Dev, Surya Dev. Follow. There is only a single chance. There is only, the only way open. As long as one does not get the scope to take dust particle from the lotus feet of pure Guru Vaishnava, great saintly devotees, till then one cannot achieve any result from all those other activities of bhajan. They can try their best, but surely they can come out successful. This way one cannot maximum up to sattvic level. They can even go up to the level of pure sattvic. Okay, still pure sattvic level they can go. Everybody speaking is very nice devotee, great devotee is there. So rules and regulations, so purity is maintained. All okay. But still, without the kippa of pure Guru Vaishnava, on those ancient days, you know, primitive, very long ago, primitive, you know, those forest men, they used to discover fire. After that, they used to protect fire in some place, because by the help of fire, they used to take so many advantage. This way, one contact of fire is 100% necessary. Maybe condition is very favorable, you are sattvic, so high, you can, you know, saddhai, adhai, niruddhai, you are doing everything. But still, without getting a source of fire, spiritual fire, how you can ignite? How you can get spiritual fire inside your heart? Follow. What we can expect from pure Guru Vaishnava? You cannot expect a nice piece of lecture from Guru Vaishnava, because they are not professor, lecturer. You cannot expect nice of language from them, because they are not linguist. Then what you can expect from them? The direct feeling of seva they already have inside their heart. That we can expect from Guru Vaishnava. They can give a spark so that I can also, you know, ignite. Spiritual fire can take place inside my heart. Loveful fire of seva. Seva mood. So here is some speciality in this sloka. Baba apaparga bhamato jada bhavet janasya tarihi achyuta sasamagamah sasangamayarhi tadaiva sadagato paravareshe tvai jati matihi arati. When the material life of a wandering soul has come to an end approximately, O Chutta, the Jivatma then can attain, get the association of your devotees. And when the Jivatma can get association with them, pure association, then and there, awakens in her. Jivatma is feminine gender, so I can use her. So there awakens in her devotion unto you. Unto mean you mean the Supreme Lord. And follow. When the material life of a wandering soul has come to an end, O Achyuta, see, I mean the Jivatma can attain the association of your devotees, get the scope, get the association of your devotees, and when she associates with them, there awakens in her devotion unto you. I mean the lotus feet of Supreme Lord, who is the goal of our devotee. What is the ultimate goal of pure devotees? Supreme Lord. Who is the goal of the devotees and the Lord of all causes and their effects. Bhava paparaka bhamato jada bhavet janasso tarhi achyuta sasamagamaha sasangama jarhi tadaiva sadagatu paravareshe tvai jayate ruti. It's a very important thing. It may be question, there can be one question. When will bhakti, one question can come inside our heart. When will bhakti, which destroys all sufferings and bestows all bliss, appear? This question. Then here, question answer given here. This question is answered in this verse. Muchukunda speaking, Ha Achyuta. Muchukunda speaking, Ho Achyuta. When a wandering spirit souls bondage in this material existence is going to be destroyed. Muchukunda speaking, Ho Achyuta. When a wandering spirit souls bondage in this material existence is going to be destroyed, she gets the association of merciful sadhus. Satsangamaha. Merciful sadhus. Their heart always going to melt. They are so merciful. Merciful sadhus, I mean satsangamaha. Then that Jivatma, she gets the association of merciful sadhus, satsangamaha. Here, very spectacular thing, those who are reading Vyakaran, Sanskrit, they can understand more clearly. The word tadaiva, tadaiva mean, you know, tadaiva one then. The word tadaiva means then and only then. Tadaiva means those who have basic conception of Sanskrit, for them I am speaking, tada eva. Tadaiva mean tada eva. Tada means then, eva means affirmative. Only and only then. The word tadaiva means then and only then. In this verse, when, I mean jarhi, and then tada are spoken in regard to a broad conception of time. In this verse, jarhi and tada, I mean in this verse, when means jarhi, when, jarhi and then tada are spoken in regard to a broad conception of time. Follow. In a more accurate description of time, it would be more proper to say that saintly association come first and cessation of material existence come afterwards. We should speak this way. Long ago, I was giving you some conception of present time. I was giving, you can remember. Conception of present time. Actually, if you calculate, nothing is present. We are always applying some extended, conception, broad conception. Actually, present, present, P, when I speak, Then the pea already gone in the book of past. P, when I speak, gone past. R, gone past. So present tense is so fine, so fine. We are always using it in exam. Where you are living? You are living here. So in this verse, when jarhi and then tada are spoken in regard to a broad conception of time. In a more precise way, if you like to speak, in a more accurate description of time, it would be more proper to say that saintly association comes first, and the cessation of material existence come afterwards. Material samsara are going away afterward. First, sadhu sangha is prior need, first of all. The cause and effect I was discussing, you can remember. Cause and effect. When I am discussing in science cause and effect, karya karan, in Sanskrit, karan karya, cause and effect. If cause is not there, effect where from you get? Follow. Cause and effect is, you know, related to each other. Very. So, cessation of material existence come afterwards. Since there, respectively, the cause and the effect. Karya karan, cause and effect, if you discussed, first of all, you will have to speak more clearly. That first of all, you are going to cut your sansar. Or first of all, you are going to get association. Well, Maharaj, it is written, it is more accurate description of time. In a more accurate description of time, it would be more proper to say that saintly association comes first and then cessation of material existence comes afterwards. Since they are respectively, first one is cause, and the second one is that effect. I mean, material samsara going. I am going to cut that desire for material samsara. Affinity gone. A second time. First is sadhu sangha. Cause and effect. Karya karan. But why it is written just opposite? Now our question is there. Why in this sloka it is just written opposite? What can be the reason? However, because the effect happens so quickly. Try to understand. Cause and effect when happening almost simultaneously. Labamattu sadhusange sarvasiddhi hoy. Labamattu sadhusange, fraction of second sadhusanga, even a fraction of second sadhusanga is more than enough. Labamattu. 1 second divided by 11. 1 second divided by 11, that much time is more than sufficient for you or me, bonded soul, to get Krishna Prema even. Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving explanation. So what to speak more? That much time is also very fraction. 11, 1 second divided by 11. I mean almost within twinkling of eyes. Everything can happen. So, Sukadev Goswami, under the guidance of Vasudev Goswami, is speaking this way. Why? Because, however, because the effect happens so quickly, almost within no time gap. When karya and karan, cause and effect, going to happen within no time interval, within simultaneously it is happening. However, because the effect happens so quickly, the effects is mentioned even before the cause to emphasize the quickness. How quickly and rapidly, I mean, we almost within no time gapping, it is happening. To give this kind of idea, This way it is written. It's one kind of technique in grammar. However, because the effect happens so quickly, the effects is mentioned even before what to speak. First of all, you have to speak cause then effect. But here it is just opposite reading. Just the effect is mentioned even before the cause to emphasis, to give, you know, importance of this word. So quickly to emphasize the quickness. This is an example of the fourth type of extreme statement known as atishayakti. It is one kind of art in grammar, in literature, when somebody going to give so much importance to one word. This is an example of the fourth type of extreme statement known as atishayokti. Very, very, with, you know, in exaggerated form, to give much more importance they are speaking. That's why effect is first speaking, then cause is after. Follow. A statement in which the logical order of cause and its effect is reversed. A statement when some poet or writer going to write in such a way is going to represent one in sentence. A statement in which the logical order of a cause and its effects is reversed, just opposite, should be understood as atishayakti. Emphasis by extreme assertion. The Vaishnava Tasani explained,
Vishnu Chakudvi quoting this point. The Vaishnava Tasani going to explain the word Sadgatau. Sadgatau means goal of the sand. Follow. What is the goal of those sadhu? Those are pure sadhu, what is their goal? They are kapat sadhu, their goal is separate. But those who are pure devotee, surely their goal is the lotus feet of Supreme Lord. I am sure about it. Any other goal, if present, then he is not a lotus sadhu. So surely, one and a single goal for sadhu, lotus feet of Supreme Lord. This word sadgatau means goal of sadhu. Tadaiva sadgatau. Amen. In him whose shelter are the devotees. Bhagavan, without Bhagavan, without the shelter of Bhagavan, those devotees cannot stay. They are already inclined to Supreme Lord. In him, I mean in Bhagavan, lotus feet, those shelters are the devotees. This is shown in such phrases as Secha Mayasso. Bhagavan, somebody can start argument that Bhagavan is omnipresent, Bhagavan is, you know, willful. Janma dasyato anmeya dhitarascharta savigya sarat. Is sarat, is not under the control of anybody. So how we can say, by the mercy of sadhu, why you cannot speak that by the mercy of Bhagavan? This is the point. Because Bhagavan is Sechamaya. Sechamani is going to reserve the full right of his own power, everything. Whatever he like to do, willpower is there. already reserved with Supreme Lord. So if somebody is going to speak this way, then that point is there. Actually, it is the arrangement of Supreme Lord. Nobody can get control over Supreme Lord. It is true. But it is the arrangement of Supreme Lord that Bhagavan is always controlled by pure devotees. Bhagavan going to sell himself to devotees. Many times Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in Chaitanya Jaya you can find. Many times Mahaprabhu speaking to some devotees, I am actually sold to you. I am actually sold to you. You can sell me anywhere. Follow. Also you can remember Advaita Gosai going to Advaita Gosai Mahavishnu. He is going to worship the Supreme Lord. He is also Swayamrup Bhagavan. He is going to call Krishna. In that case, it is written in Gautamiya Tantra, one sloka. Tulsidal Matrena, there is one sloka. Advaita Gosai Abhivraptiti coming, we have to discuss. Tulsidal Matrena Jalasya Chalukena Va Vrikrinita Samatmanam Bhaktibva Bhaktavasala. Follow, Gautamiya Tantra. From this source, Advaita Gosai is going to watch one sloka. That Tulsidala Matrena Jalasya Chalukena Va. By also Tulsidal. Tulsidal, Tulsi Manjari. Advaita Gosai watching, it is written that Tulsidala Matrena Jalasya Chalukena Va. With Gangajal and Tulsi leaf, you are going to offer unto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord. Bhagavan become restless. How to pay him? Bhagavan like to sell himself in front of that devotee. Of course, if he is doing with, you know, Niskinjan Bhakti, if he is he is very powerful, rich, then he should not imitate. So it is written, Tulasi Dala Matrena Jalasya Chalukena Va Vrikrinite Sumatmanam Bhaktibva Bhaktavasala. A Bhaktavasala Bhagavan, if somebody is going to give some water and Tulsidal, Niskinjan devotee is going to, then Bhagavan thinking, how I can sell myself in front of that devotee. So it is true, Bhagavan can never be controlled by anybody. But still, it is also true, Bhagavan can only be controlled by pure devotees. Follow. Bhagavan can hunt you. So actually everything Krishna does, everything depends upon the desire of Krishna. But still, the desire of devotees is more important. Actually everything Krishna does is initiated by the desire of his devotees. Jada jada hidharamasya glanir bhavati bharata abhutanam adharamasya tadatmanam srijamyaham paritrana yusadhunam vinasayascha duskritam sambhavami yuge yuge. Here it is Vishwanatha Chakravarti giving explanation. That to save devotees, paritranaya sadhuna. Now Vishwanatha Chakravarti is giving explanation. Those sadhu, they are not going to pray anything in front of Krishna. Please save me. This also they cannot say. Vishwanatha Chakravarti speaking, if suppose somehow some pure devotee is speaking out, by chance, it is not his habit. By chance, he cannot speak, he is not habituated. You know, follow. Visajalapayat bala rakshasat. This sloka in Gopi Gita. Visajalapayat bala rakshasat. Vaidutanalat. You know, from thunderbolt, from poison water, from fire, all the time you are saving. But the devotee not going to, you know, because they are not. But still, Vishnu was with you, Anugraha, those sadhus, they are never going to speak that way. Then what can be the reason? The devotee never pray anything. Then Vishwanath was speaking that the devotee, they want to get rescue from the ocean of separation, painful separation, Vijinarnabhat. In Sanskrit we say Vijinarnabhat, the painful experience of separation. That's why, save me from this painful ocean of, you know, separation. This is yes, speaking. So ultimately it is written, actually everything Krishna does is initiated by the desire of devotees. When you can remember, when Brahma or demigod, they are going to pray, Bhagavan will say, well, I know, you go, I'm going to take birth, I can incarnate, I can come. So, therefore, his mercy is also dependent on the saintly devotees. There is no mistake in Siddhanta. Actually, everything Krishna does is okay. Actually, everything Krishna does is initiated by the desire of his devotees. Therefore, his mercy is also dependent on the saintly devotees. In this phrase, sadgatau, this word, it is it is implied in this phrase, the sadgatau, it is implied that Krishna is not the gati, the goal of those non-devotees, asat, those were asat, impious asat. In this phrase, sadgato, when you indicate for sadhu, it implies that Krishna is not the goal, I mean gati, of those who are asat. Follow, material people, this word. This means that Krishna's mercy can be received only when a succession of, you know, succession of previous sins has been established. What I mean to say, you can remember, I was speaking that day, that parampara dhara, kripa, through parampara coming to us. Follow, what is it? This means, is one can look at parampara shakti, kripa, also can come. If there is no parampara, then a breakage. This means that Krishna's mercy can be received only when a succession of, you know, previous sons has been established. It doesn't arise all by itself. Sometime, you know, it does not arise all by itself. Sometime in the past. The point is confirmed in the second sloka also. Second sloka also, they are same sloka just after. Baba Pabarga Bhamato Yadat Bhavijana Satarhi Achyuta Sasamagamaha Sasangamajarhi Tadaiva Sadagatu Paravareshi Tvai Jati Matihi Arhatihi. Another sloka, just like sloka, Muchukunda speaking, Swayam Samuttirjo Sudustvaram Duman Bhavarnavam Bhimam Adabhrao Sohida Bhavat bhavat padam boru bhavat padam boruhon na nava matro te nidhayo yataha sadanugroho bhavano swayam samuttirjo sudustaram duman bhavarnavam bhima madabhra sohidaha bhavat padam boruho nava matro te nidhayo yataha sadanugroho Bhavan, O Lord, who resembled the shining sun, you are always ready to fulfill the desire of your devotees. And therefore, you are known as Banchakalpataru. You are known as wishing tree. Therefore, you are known as wishing tree, Banchakalpataru. When acharyas completely take shelter, be careful. When acharyas, only those acharyas, be careful. When acharyas completely take shelter under your lotus feet, in order to cross over this fearful ocean of material world, they leave behind on earth the method by which, you know, by method by which they already cross. And because you are very merciful to your other devotees, so you accept this method to help. Try to understand. Like the example in 10th canto, 11th canto also, you know, there is written that this body, you know, can be compared with a boat. And Guru is a crewman who is going to help us. Nideha madhyam sulabam sudurlabam plavam guru kanudharam. You can remember this sloka I discussed many times before. So it is, Bhagavan is so merciful that previous acharyas, big, big sadhus, how they are going to cross this material ocean? By the help of bhakti, they are going to give this kind of, you know, glowing example. They are going to set one remarkable example in front of us so that we can also get inspiration to cross over the material ocean. We can get inspiration. Follow what I say. Previous, all our previous Guru Varga, they are doing seva in nice way, so nice way, practicing acharyas. Same way. Nideha madhyam sulabam sudurlabam guru karunadharam. This sloka you should remember. This way they are going to cross over the material. They are going to see, they are going to show us that this is the procedure. My son, this is the procedure. So you can follow same procedure as I was following. So this way you also, I am showing you how to cross over this material ocean. You can very easily cross over. You can go away. Why you are waiting? This way you can also cross over this material ocean. So always, if somebody is going to speak that bhakti is impossible to get, there is no sadhu at all, he is actually Mayavadi. He should not speak this way. He should not speak this way because he wants to prove that Jagannath is so weak that Jagannath has no power to keep even one sadhu in this material world so that we can get the chance to cross over the material world. Bhagavan is so, you are going to prove, na? Those who are Mayavadi, they like to prove. This is their evidence. They like to prove that Bhagavan is very weak. Mayavadi, Bhagavan has no power. Bhagavan cannot keep even one sadhu so that we can see one example, glowing example, idealism, and we can get inspiration and cross over the material world. What do you mean to say? We should not speak this way. Always there is sadhu. Prabhupada told, Bhakti Vinod Dara kakhano avaruddha havena. Bhakti Vinod Dara can never be extinct. Never stop. Somehow, maybe you cannot see, you are blind, Maybe you are blind, you cannot see, but Bhakti Vinod Tara is always there. Bali should be there, was sadhu. If you have some politics, you have some properties and laws account, if you are thinking about personal pratishtha, then you cannot see. This personal pratishtha, personal interest can make you blind. You cannot see practicing acharya is not there. You can speak pass this kind of remark. Also, Bhagavan is there always with. Bhagavan is always there with Jivatma. Bhagavan is always there with Jivatma. Also, Bhagavan is going to send Sadhu Guru Vaishnava practically to show the example. Like about Prahlad Maharaj, Bhagavan speaking. If somebody going to ask me, Nishingadev speaking, Prahlad, if somebody going to ask me that you give one example of your devotee, I like to refer your name. No, Prahlad Maharaj. Nishingadev speaking, I can give you an example. Madhbhakta Pratirupadrik. Madhbhakta Pratirupadrik. How your disciple is like? We like to see. Then I can quote your name, refer your name. Madhbhakta Pratirupadrik. We are really, you know, we have no gratefulness. You see, all the time Bhagavan trying to send his dham, nam, devotees, leelas, Ganga, Juna, everything. All devotees, all facilities. Not only that, but also Bhagavan going to sit inside the heart of everybody as Paramatma. Follow. Bhagavan is also staying inside the heart of Paramatma. I can discuss this point. That Paramatma, Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing, that in the form of Paramatma, Aniruddha Vishnu going to stay in the heart of everybody, a super soul. Paramatma. By the Paramatma, this is also Bhagavan, actually we can prove that Paramatma, Bhagavan, Aniruddha Vishnu coming in the form of Paramatma inside the heart of everybody, but this is also not eternally present. Only one kind of Paramatma Vaibhav. Paramatma Vaibhav. We are going to see Paramatma Vaibhav. Bhagavan can manifest in the form of, you know, Paramatma, but this is also eternal feature is not there. Only inside creation, when creation takes place, Bhagavan, you know, creation and inside the heart of Jivatma already there all the time. And in this material world, manifestation of Bhagavan in the form of Paramatma is also not long-lasting. In this material world, Jivatma with Jivatma eternally present. Because Jivatma is Chit Atma, spiritual constituent, and Chit particle. In material world, actually, this one kind of Vaibhav. Bhagavan going to express his Vaibhav, Paramatma Vaibhav. In Sandarbha, Jiva Goswami writing. Follow. And this material world, we think very active because of this Chidatma present. Chidatma, like I give the example of electricity. If electricity is not there, machine is there, everything is there, machine cannot run. Electricity, you cannot touch, you cannot see. Electricity, you cannot see. But electricity is there. Immense power. So without electricity, a factory cannot go. Everything there, director is there, raw material there, or foreman there, engineer there, labors there, all ready. But factory not running. Why? But Maharaj, there is no electricity. All arrangement there, everything there, all infrastructure, everything okay. All ready, but still without current, nothing. Similarly, Prakriti is nature. When I can discuss about this creation, mystery of creation. In the there you can see that matter, this miniature is matter, total. In contact with Jivatma or Chiratma, it seems the Prakriti has life, you know. This way, this Prakriti, I mean material nature, I mean Durga acting, she is, you know, Prakriti Kriyamanani. Prakriti, how? Prakriti, by the help of the Satarajatama, it is also matter. But Prakriti Kriyamanani Guna Karma, you know, by the indication of this Maya, I mean three modes of nature, Jivas, they are dancing according to a gesture. They have nothing to do, as if puppet on a chain. How nice. Bhumi rapa analo vayu khang manabuddhi revacha ahankar iti yamme prakriti rastata. Your mind, you are thinking, is also matter, but you can, you are not ready to agree. Your brain, buddhi, you are going to take this, is also matter. Bhagavan speaking, all matter, material thing, but it seems has a magical spell in your life. You are controlled by these three modes of nature, this, that. So, in Bhagavan is so merciful, that they should not complain. They should not blame Supreme Lord. That's why I am discussing this point. From Shetashvatara Upanishad, fourth part, 6, and also in Mundak Suti, 3.1.1. Rig Veda also, 1.164.21. Sloka, same sloka. Shetashvatara 4 and 6, 4 stroke 6, 4 chapter 6 sloka. It is written, very famous look, everybody knows. Da suparna sajuja sa sakhaya samanam vriksham parisajvati tayoranno pippalam swad atpi anasnan anne avi chakasiti. Da suparna sajuja sakhaya samanam vriksham pari sajjate tayoranyaha pippalam svad atti anasnan anne anne abhi chakasiti. What I mean to say, two birds from Gita, perhaps you have gone through Gita, Urdhamulam Adhosakham, this Bhuvanadrum, in Bhagavatam it is Bhuvanadrum, this material world is one kind of tree. How many branches this there? And root is there up. Urdhamulam Adhosakham. All branches and trees, usually trees are there in upright position. I mean tree, you know, fruits and flower up, and the branches and roots are there down in the ground. But here just opposite. Sanshara drum, the material sansara is compared with your tree. And the root is there up, or branches. Branches there, trees, you know, leaf and branches. So the suparna sajuja is one kind of tree. Material sansara is compared with your tree. Kiradaka Sai Vishnu. And the jivas are residing in this temporary body. Follow what I say. Puranjan, you can remember, someday I was discussing. Very nice, Puranjan. Puranjan, Naraji Maharaj going to discuss about this Puranjan. It is fictitious story. But still it is not fictitious. Follow. You try to understand why I speak this way. You cannot catch sky, but you cannot ignore the conception of sky. Maharaj, sky is there. A sky is there, conception of sky. But you can catch sky, you cannot sky. But sky is there, you cannot deny. Mind is there, you cannot catch. So many things, you know, there. So you cannot deny. Impossible for you to deny. Existence there, we cannot touch. Follow what I say. So Puranjan, one though externally you can find one very nice story, but has some link with practical, you know, science of this life. Puranjan, one jivatma going to take shelter into a nice body, nice beautiful lady, woman or man, handsome man. Nobody can realize that way. I am mad. I am going to speak this way. The day you can see only Atma, no man, no woman. The day you can feel, see, then I think you are enjoying full Guru Kripa. Without which impossible. We are busy with your material body. If some sickness coming, we break down. Oh, I am sick. Anyway, we are going to leave our body. Any amount of medicine, any amount of, you know, care, I can take, I can try, but I cannot live here in this material. This is temporary, all temporary arrangement. Tomorrow I can discuss this point. Shuddha Suparna Sajuja Sakhayam Samanam Briksham Parishajyate. The sloka, Kirata Gosai Vishnu and the Jiva, both of them are residing in a temporary body. Like two friendly birds, like two friendly birds in Upanishad, in Jain Setasada, in a tree. This body is compared with tree, and his body, in his tree, there is two birds. One is Paramatma, another is Jivatma. Follow. Like two friendly birds, you know, in a pipal tree. Pipal tree, it is written there, pipal tree. But we can compare it, these are our temporary body. Anyhow, we cannot protect our body and anything belonging to our bodies. We cannot protect, give protection. Tavad vayam dabina deha sahit nimityam tavas priha paribhava vipulas chalova. You know, I was speaking now, just 1 hour before. This temporary body, it can be pipal tree. So, there are two birds, they are like two friendly birds in a pipal tree. This can be compared with this material body, temporary body. Of these two birds, one jiva going to eat, or going to take the taste of fruits of this material world, material samsara. Try to follow this darshan, very fruits of this. You know, they are going to take the fruits, I mean eat the fruits of the tree according to the karmaphal of the jivatma, according to the karmaphal of that jivatma, jivatma surely going to get karmaphal. Avasvameva bhaktavyo kitakarmam shubhasubham. Surely we'll have to take the result of action what you are doing. Karma. So one of those two birds, one the jiva going to eat fruits. Fruits of the tree according to her, I mean jivatma's karma phal. While the other, I mean Paramatma, does not taste, I mean eat the fruits, but simply observing Jivatma. Simply observe as a witness only. Only going to stay inside the heart, going to watch, and Paramatma is the eternal friend of Jivatma. But we forget, always crying when Jivatma going to face any, when Jivatma going to face any kind of trouble and problem, so many, you know, all the time, the case of pain and pleasure, any amount Jivatma getting, Paramatma not going to leave Jivatma. Even when in Vrindavan one Pandit asking me, when Jivatma going to hell, then where Paramatma going? I will say why? Hell, heaven is applicable only for Jivatma, not for Paramatma. Paramatma Vaibhav, Paramatma is always there. Even when Jivatma going to hell, Paramatma crying, watching the painful situation of the Jivatma and speaking, as if speaking, I never told you to take the risk of, you know, this kind of painful situation. I never told you. But you are yourself, whimsical attitude, you are doing it. So this way, actually, this samsara is just like a peepal tree in which this material body, peepal tree, two birds are staying. One of those conditioned jiva and others are friends. Ishvara Paramatma, there. First bird, Jivatma, going to test, eat the fruits of the tree, while the other bird simply watches her. This means the Jivatma who is bound by Maya, performs karma and enjoys the fruits that Ishvara, the Lord of Maya, awards according to the Jiva's karma. For this, you cannot blame for that. That's why in Gita, from Gita also I was discussing, you can remember the sloka. Na adatte kasyajit papam na caiva sukritim vibhum agyaneno avritam jnanam tena muhyanti yantavaha. From Vedanta also I was speaking, though Jivatma, they are going to get their own result of karma, Bhagavan can never be blamed. But surely, one very basic point is there. Karma phal, bija, karma bija is there. Follow, kam bija, karma bija is there. But bija is there. If there is no rainfall and sunlight, how bija can sprout? Not possible. So ultimate cause is Bhagavan. Even Duryodhan going to speak this way. Duryodhana also not going to blame Krishna. Duryodhana, wicked Duryodhana, he is also not going to blame Krishna. Duryodhana speaking, that I know what is dharma. Janami dharmam nachame prabritti, janami adharmam nachame nibritti, tayarisikesa hiristitena yatha niyuktosmi tatha karomi. What does it mean? Even wicked Duryodhana speaking, I know what is dharma. But I have no desire to follow dharma. Janami dharmam nachame prabhitti. I am not my, you know, prabhitti is not there. Desire is not there to follow dharma. And janami adharmam. I know what is adharma. But still I cannot avoid doing adharma. I know what is, this is adharma. But still I like to do it. Because according to my previous karma fall, I am doing directly or indirectly, all the controlling is in the hand of Bhagavan. But Bhagavan anyway not going to interfere with the free will of all Jivatma. Many, many questions coming to me. I'm giving answer this way. So, why must Jiva suffer for the sake of Bhagavan's pastime? This question can come. Sometime question coming, why at all Bhagavan going to give them free will? Bhaktivinoda giving all answer. You know, why Jivatma or Jiva going to suffer? Why? We know this case so many for the Leela of Bhagavan. Joy Vijay already told, Bhagavan is saturated, no desire, nothing. But still Bhagavan going to enjoy, play, going to do Leela. Birras, Jai Vijay coming, to satisfy Supreme Lord. This way, all the time I can give him so many examples. Also, pure devotees, they are not going to blame. They are always thinking, Tomar shevai dukha hai yato sevata param sukh. When devotee is going to serve Bhagavan, if there is any kind of problem, then never Sheva, Sukha, Dukha, Parama, Sampad, Nasai, Abhidhadu. Bhaktivinoda Thakur sometimes in Kirtan writing, na? Pashupakki ve taki sargeva niraye tava bhakti rohu bhakti vinodo hidaye. It matters little which body is there. That's why it is written, why Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing? Not that only human, this Bhagavad Dharma is so open, so liberal, so, you know, scientific. It is applicable for all Jivatma. Otherwise, Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing, why? I can give example day by day to show you. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing, Pashu Pakki Ve Taki, birds and beasts. Any Janma, I can take birth, but Prabhu, I pray you. I like to get bhakti. Pashi pakki ve taki sargeva niraye tava bhakti rohu bhakti vinodo hidaye. Bhakti me tell praying. You know. Vittasur also. Indra was just stunned. Indra was just stunned, gone mad to see the devotional mood of Vittasur. Indra was just mad. How it is possible? I see you are demon. A demon, you know, in Tamagun. Radagun, Tamagun. How you are expressing this kind of tatta, loveful, you know, prayer to Supreme Lord, I go mad. Indra going to ask to Vrittasura, how it is possible for you? Indra speaking, Jad asura bhavam vihayo mahapurushatam gataha. I am stunned because jad asuram bhavam vihayo mahapurushatam gataha. You are in the form of asur, but you are speaking prayer just like a great devotee. Really so? He has chitta ketu. He is a great devotee. He is the disciple of Sankarsana. But he is one kind of leela. Is one kind of leela. Jai Vijaya also coming in the form of Ravan in Kumbhakarna. This way, Shishupal, Dantabharga, all, you know. Is one kind of leela. If leela is not there, with whom? If Adyagantatta, if you are established in Adyagantatta, you should remember, nothing there except Krishna. Really so? Directly, indirectly, there is nothing except Krishna. Infinity diversity, he also under the control of this Adyagantatta. We have no complaint about it. You see, why Devaki Ma going to suffer all six of his sons, all six of her sons were killed by Kansa? Why Devaki Ma need to suffer? Why? What can be the reason? She is the mother of Krishna. You cannot put this question. Because devotees, they have no complaint. They understand Adyagantatta. They know all by the desire of Krishna. Bonded soul can start weeping, shedding tears. Jamal Arjun, Leela, if Naraji Maharaj, I already just half an hour before I was speaking, discussing Baba Apabar Godi Sloka. The Sanatana Gosai writing, na? Krishna always going to do anything by the desire of Supreme Lord. So Jamal Arjun going to get curse from Naraji Maharaj. That is also one indication. Naraji Maharaj going to do according to the desire of Krishna. Jai Vijaya going to get curse from Chatusvan by the desire of Krishna. Krishna himself told, Narayan told, when Chatusvan speaking, Prabhu, we have done mistake, great mistake, we have done offense, we curse, you know. Prabhu said, no. Your curse is according to my desire. This is my pre-plan. So I am So Jamal Arjun going to suffer, you know. Jamal Arjun going to suffer, but Jamal Arjun going to suffer two sons of Kuber. Kuber, you know, the goddess of riches. Eh? Jamal Arjun, as you know, they are in the form of Jamal Arjun Viksha. You know, follow. Nalkubar or Manigrib. Nalkubar, Manigrib. If they are not going to get the curse from Naraji Maharaj, how we can get this kind of teachings? How we can get? Follow. Also, this kind of Leela, Jamal Arjun ultimately going to get the Kipa. All you can get, take the example of, you know, that Indradyumna Maharaj was cursed by Agastya Muni to take the body of elephant. Ultimately, it was curse or blessing? It was curse or blessing, you speak. It's blessing. Otherwise, how it was possible for that elephant, in the body of elephant, you can remember, the elephant can remember. Yeah. Jajap paramam japyam prag janmanu sikshitam. Started chanting that mantra. Already he got in previous life. Jajap paramam japyam prag janmanu sikshitam. Prag janmanu sikshitam. Anusikshitam mean he was taught by Guru. Anusikshitam. Not directly teaching. I mean, Guru Kipa was there. Somehow making mistake. It is one kind of Leela. It is one kind of Leela. Then after that, finally, Jamal Arjun going to take birth as a, you know, Arjun tree in the courtyard of Nanda Maharaj in Gokul. Finally, the enjoying Kipa. Follow. Is Kipa. After breaking the two trees, Krishna going to bestow Kipa on them. Hello. And finally, you can find so many things. I don't like to discuss so many things. And they also getting the chance to enter into Krishna Leela there. They are singing song in the Sabha of Nanda Maharaj to satisfy Krishna. Madhukanta and Snigdhakanta, two in this stage, they are going to take part. Every day they are going to sing in front of Krishna, you know, the prince of the kingdom, Nanda Maharaj's, you know, son, Krishna Balaram, they are going to sing. Madhukanta, Snigdhakanta, they are going to sing. So is curse or blessing? Bhaktivinoda want to prove, no. Also, Nanda Baba was abducted by Barunji Maharaj. How it is possible, Maharaj? How it is possible, he is the father? Come on, he is the father of Krishna. How dare the workers of Barun Maharaj can abduct Nanda Maharaj? All by the desire of Krishna. Barun. And Nanda Maharaj was abducted by Barun Anuchar, servants of Barun, gone there. That is why Krishna get the chance to reach there. Barun going to get Kipa from Krishna. Also this kind of love for father, eternal father of course. Otherwise you can also start loving father than me. So, Barun Katri, by Barun, he was abducted, this kind of Kaliyadaman. Are Kaliyadaman, Kaliyanag is very terrific poison, and those, you know, this, you know, cows, you know, coward boys, they fall down there. All the painful situation of those gopikas without cloth after taking bath in Jamuna in Hemanta autumn. You can remember Bastaran Leela. Prahlad going to undergo so many painful, you know. So many pain. Otherwise, how we can get example? It is one kind of drama. If Prahlad Maharaj not going to say, if there in this material world, there should be policeman, there if policeman is inactive, policeman is inactive. I heard one country is there, very small country, Netherlands or Sweden, I don't know, I forget. There no need of policeman. They are all controlled, they are civilized, very, very small country. I forget that name of their land. There is police not, they are already controlled. Yeah, by chance some police is at all there, they have no danda. No firing, you know, pistol, no, they are controlling, like human being. So nice. This way, somebody has to suffer. Somebody has to suffer. They are all, you know, Prahlad going to suffer. So this kind of for the Leela of Nisringadev, otherwise Nisringadev cannot appear. We cannot have this example. So we cannot anyway blame. Jivas possess this, those jivas, they possess some independence, as I can discuss next day. This is actually a symptom of Bhagavan's kripa, special mercy upon them, jivas. Why you are thinking opposite way? Inert objects, insignificant objects, all matter here, you know, no life you cannot see. Achaditi chetan, covered up chetan is there, trees. You know, inert objects are very insignificant and worthless. Because they have no such independence, jise, the jivas had attained sovereignty of the inert world, mayar bharta. In Bengali you say, jivatma, all jivatma, they want to imitate Krishna. Krishna is the supreme enjoyer. All jivatma, I am also enjoyer. I can also, but what they can enjoy? They can enjoy prakriti, nature. Body upon woman is also nature. Body of a man, also nature, atma, you cannot see, is inside there. So who is going to enjoy whom? Try to understand, play your head. Who is going to whom? Who is going to enjoy whom? Prakriti kya manani. Only the false ego, karta aham iti mannati. False. Chidatma, saprakas bhaktu, chidatma, gyanamaya vastu, Chidatma Prakasmaya Vastu, I already told, full of enjoyment, but where from this kind of covering coming up Maya? Now, like mat. Pisachi Paile Jatha Matichanna Hai. Pisachi Paile Jatha Matichanna Hai Maya Vaddha Jivir Hai Seibhavudhai. Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami speaking, just like a man in normal conditions, very good. When a evil spirit going to enter into the body, then he is to like ghost. He is breaking, making this, that, you know, learning here and there. It's very dangerous. Evil spirit already take over the control of the consciousness there already, because you are very weak. If your consciousness is very high, no mantra, tantra, sarayantra, conspiracy, you know, any kind of attempt of black magic cannot act. Provided your Chetan Sakti has gone up very high by the mercy of Guru Kripa. Try to understand and remember. So any Jivatma going to feel that I am the enjoyer of this Prakriti, nature. Are nature is not a matter of enjoyment. But you think I can enjoy? That is a disease. Follow. Inert objects are very insignificant and worthless, because they have no such independence is there. Willpower is there with Chidatma, I already told, Chit particle. Spontaneous knowledge is there, covered up, all is there. Prakashmay, you know, self-effulgence is there with Jivatma, but all covered up. The Jiva has attended sovereignty, Jiva man, bonded soul. Has attended sovereignty of inert world only because of her, I mean Jivatma, independent desire, willpower. I am the enjoyer. That is why. That is the only disease. Misery and happiness are condition of the material mind. Many time before I told, pain and pleasure, you can feel by the help of your material mind. Atma not going to undergo any pain and pleasure, nothing. Eternal enjoyment is already there. Try to remember many time before. You cannot remember. That is the main problem. If I take you minus 20 degree temperature, oh my God, you please take me, I'm feeling very, you know, problem here. You cannot stay because you are not habituated. If somebody habituated in minus 20 degree, if I going to put him in Rajasthan, hot place, 46, 47, oh my God, take me there very quickly. So if something is favorable for you, that is not favorable for another jivatma. Follow. If there is any fixed conception of pain and pleasure, then it should be common for all. You are feeling comfortable, but I am not feeling comfortable. You are feeling comfortable to take, you know, to get up, you know, maybe 7 o'clock, 6 o'clock. Bhagavan, sadhu not habituated. He is not going to get up 3 o'clock. He feel all my day gone. Habituated. So what is, there is no eternal existence. Try to understand. There is no eternal existence of pain and pleasure, but you are going to give so much importance to this point. Oh, I am feeling fine. I'm sick. I cannot stay this way. Because in bonded condition, it's quite natural. Try to think over and again this point. It is feasible for you. It is not feasible. Follow. In Gita, so many today interruption due to internet problem. Hindi Gita explanation was not done. I couldn't do. I'm very sorry. I waste my time, you know. This way, you know, there is in Gita everything. For Rajasik, for Tamasik and Swatik, their habit, their behavior, their food intake habit, everything clarified there in Gita. But Shuddha Satik Bhumika one sadhu, what I can expect from Srila Siddhar Goswami Maharaj and Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj, surely I cannot expect it from you. Impossible. Follow what I say. So, pain and pleasure, this word is in a fake term. Fake mean? In the material world, for this, up to this point is okay. But beyond this material bondage, beyond condition is not applicable. Because no eternal existence. You are going to give so much value to this conception of pain and pleasure. But be sure, no eternal existence of pain and pleasure there. What you are giving? So much importance. But whereas you are not giving importance for your, what your Atma, what your spirit, what your, you know, pure soul want to get Krishna Seva, that you are not thinking about. Follow what I say. So, pain and pleasure have no eternal existence, all fake. Only the arrangement of Maya, Satarajatama Guna, what you are feeling pain, somebody won't feel happy for that. So, inert object, they are insignificant, worthless, because they have no such independence. The Jiva has attained a sovereignty of the inert world. They are to enjoy material world, Prakriti, only because this Jivatma, they have independent desire. Misery and happiness are condition of the material mind, nothing else. You know. Thus, what we may consider misery is happiness for one Jivatma. Follow. Another Jivatma is very happy. Since all varieties of material sense gratification finally result in nothing but misery. Jehi sangsparsaja bhogaha, try to understand. Jehi sangsparsaja bhogaha, duksha janayevati, Adyantabantukantiyo Nati Shuramati Buddha. How Arjun, those who are really intelligent, they never go for sensual enjoyment because they are not fool. Jehi Sangsparsaja Bhogaha Duksha Jane Evati Adyantabantukantiyo Nati Shuramati Buddha. The starting point of your enjoyment, material enjoyment, and the ending point of material enjoyment is there, not eternal. Follow. So, since all varieties of material sense gratification, enjoyment finally result in nothing but misery, materialistic person only achieves suffering, nothing else. So we have no right to blame Krishna. I can go on discussing this point, very important, from different angle. I like to discuss this point. So, this way you see, we have whom to blame? We have nothing to blame. We cannot blame. We are going to get the result of our own karma fall. Bhavapabharga bhamato yada bhavichanaswa tarhi achyata satsamagama satsangama jarhi tadaiva sadagatu paravare setai jayate ratihi vanchakalpataru sikipasindu vivacha patitanan pavana bhavishnabhyo namo.